we were made to relive 75 and 76 in Australia. Every time the highlights were shown of one of those test matches, you were never given the chance to just put it in the back of your mind. They kept on focusing on what happened.
It was so important for those of us who had been part of defeat in 1975 to have the opportunity to put that right.
At that stage, Australia were officially number one in the world. Still.
The West Indies had never won a test series in Australia, so this would have been breaking new ground.
We must beat Australia at all costs. It didn't matter how we did it, ugly, nice, we had to beat them. Psychologically, physically, every other adverb you could use, we were ready.
We encountered similar problems that we had in 75, 76. You know, they would walk past you or come down the track and so on, they would say off.
Off, you know?
Piss off, or you're a wanker.
You know, you're coming into bat. Before you get there, Dennis Lilly will tell you straight out, I'm going to knock your effing head off. I'm coming for that.
Lenny Pascoe, who at one point said if I'd hooked, I was going to be a hospital case.
I think that's now taking the game to a different level.
They thought that when they threw it at us, we were just going to fall over and die and remembered what happened before. But it wasn't like that. It was a completely different story.
Gets it away, cuts hard and high.
They were taken by surprise.
I wasn't a helmet man. I didn't wear all this protective gear. I knew that there'd be a lot of forces who'd be looking to get me. The message that I sent is that I'd rather die out there. The only how I'm gonna be not here is if I'm knocked out.
Oh, nasty blow, nasty blow.
Everyone was thinking, oh hell, Viv is gonna be damaged. And we're expecting Viv to be walking off the field at some point.
You cannot afford to let your opposition know when you're hurt. They stand up and they look you in the eye and I look back and we have this little steering match for a while. You know when you would have got the better of them. By the time they turn around, they pass the umpire and they get back to their mark, they will take a little look around again to see if you're still looking. I'll be still looking. You know, and that's when they know that you're serious.
The bouncer coming next ball. What an answer.
And the very next ball, he hit it straight out of the ground.
Look what you've done, you know. You just bloody well pulled a lion tail. They weren't saying kill, kill, kill for too long. And I think when Australia done that, it just motivated all players to get pretty mean.
Oh, that's a tip under the heart, a nasty blow. That was a blow that would hurt. And Joel Garner saying that you can wear that one.
The four guys who we let loose on them.
He's caught that one as well.
Was just too much.
It's been a rather painful day for the Australians.
The same Australians who were so aggressive all of a sudden were crying. Can you imagine that from an Australian, you know, I could not believe it.
The harder they come, the harder they fall. When we had the pace, and the pace get real hot, they would touch it and they would walk. Because the pace is real hot.
We were talking about a peace truce. That peace truce probably lasts for a game and then it was back to normal again. Yeah. But that is how far it went at that stage.
And we kept the pressure on the opposition and we hammered them into the ground.
They bumped shit out of them.
Wow, that I think was special.
You know, it felt as if, yes, we had really achieved something. We had learned from our experiences. And yes, we have now proven ourselves at the highest level.
You know, it really was a feeling that West Indies cricket has now come of age. And we really are the best team in the world.
This was the first time the West Indies had produced something which was the best the world had seen.
Here we are, several dots on the map, dominating the world.
It's difficult to describe the feeling even now.
There was joy beyond words.
We're on a high, it's celebration time.
Everything was working out to perfection.
We went to Pakistan and were the only team to beat Pakistan in Pakistan, ever. We went to India and beat India again as the only team to have done that.
West Indies bowling was poetry in motion at that time. And you have never seen it since.
We just wanted to win everything. We wanted to win every game. We put our feet on them, kept them down, and beat them.
You can't beat a team like that. Oh, you can beat a team like that.
When West Indies began to win so consistently, it triggered a pride in the workplace. It triggered a pride in the way we dressed, in the way we went into studios and recorded.
African culture had been criminalized and driven into the ground for 300 years. At the first opportunity to be free to express itself, it comes up to the surface and it comes back there again. And suddenly we have this extraordinary emergence of culture in the Caribbean.
Bob Marley and the Wailers, Jimmy Cliff, coming with aggression, abrasion, and a force of change. You combine all of that with a West Indies cricket success. Unbelievable. They thought that we were heroes, but to me, they were heroes. Bob Marley, come to the dressing room, telling you, you gotta win. Mascroft, man, ratted. We gotta get these men out quick. Brilliant. That's a period of history that will forever be the most productive time of our lives.
They start to boast. Instead of being ashamed, they can wave their flags and say, our heroes made us look good.
You know, all these tunes are totally inspiring stuff, you know, sounding the protest bell. Get up, stand up. Stand up, stand up. To me, it's not a crime, you know? It is about standing up for what you believe in. And you walk onto the fields and it's totally embedded in your mind. You may call it your battlefield music, you know?
I will never, ever forget Riv Richards. And as I speak about him now, I can picture him right there. In his heart burns the custom culture of Rastafari. He was rasterized, but a lot of people didn't know that came from him having to do with Bob Marley. He always find himself in the company of the Wailers. Had he not been involved in cricket, he would have surely been a dreadlock rasterman. Real deal.
Viv was very, very much the darling of Caribbean peoples, you know. He was really the extension, philosophically, of Clive Lloyd, taking it now to a further consciousness of spiritual, religious thought. Viv was really becoming into the fullness of identity as an African.
Even his armband that he wore showed the African colors.
The green for the land itself. The yellow for the gold taken away and stripped away. The red meant the blood that was shed. Those particular colors and what it meant.